Okay. Then there would be this third person who will be observing, listening, noticing, and will come up with new ideas whenever a problem arises. Right? And then there would be, finally, after solving the problems, after having problems in your friendships as well, you go there in the classroom, say, ma'am, we are ready. We'll give the presentation today. And what happens? We blank out. It happens that I had prepared 10 points and I'm talking about only 2 points there. Why? Because I saw so many eyes looking at me for the first time and I don't know how to present myself. I don't know if I'm looking good enough, if I'm sounding good enough, whether what they are thinking about me. And God forbid, if they ask you a question about your topic, you're just gone there. Yaar, ye toh prepare nahi kiya tha. So how do you handle that? That is something that is a part of your behavioral skills, your communication skills. So first you're clear about who you are, okay? How do you understand yourself? And then how do you finally present it? If I don't know who I am, if I don't know what my weaknesses and strengths are, I don't think I'm going to be able to present to you myself in a very good manner. I will be doubtful, I will be fearful, and I don't know what is going to happen. Now, the questions that we did about who would the movie character be, or what was the other question? If you had to choose an animal, who would that animal be? You know, these days, when you talk about interview preparation, trust me, guys, those days are gone when you could enter an interview and recite your poem. My name is so-and-so, I'm coming from so-and-so, my strengths are this. My weakness is that I'm a perfectionist. I work a lot. Those are my weaknesses. You have learned it so well. Your seniors have told you, aisa aisa bolna job mil jayegi. It doesn't happen anymore. These questions about probably an animal or a movie character or something apart from that is going to reveal your true personality to the interviewer without you even knowing it. If someone says that I believe myself to be a lion, a lioness, a shark maybe, okay, or maybe a wolf, the answer that I got from that side, and you tell them that because I like to lead, because I like to be the dominant one, because I like to have the power, people are fearful of me. And maybe that person is applying for the post of an assistant, where you are required to take orders, where you are required to obey the instructions and not really be assertive there. No matter how much you try to rephrase it or paraphrase it, you have given away your true personality there. And you even didn't know that maybe I am this kind of person. I tried to show I'm a team leader, I'm very assertive and dominant, but maybe your job doesn't even require you to be that. So you are unfit for that job. So even if you get hired, at the first place you won't even get hired. By chance you get hired, you will have problems working in that job. Similarly, the employer will have a problem having you hired there. You will be more like a burden there, and you yourself will be having a frustrated life that this is not what I was looking for. I can't speak out my mind there because I'm a dominant person. I want to speak up. I want to have my point. So this is where we need to understand the behavioral skills are so very important when we're talking about getting jobs, getting internships, and making a mark and place for ourselves in today's economy. And as Tanmay had talked about the advanced skills already, skills like digital skills, big data analysis, social media handling, idea generation, financial management, these are very far-fetched skills. You can't go to the fourth story of a building if you haven't climbed the first, second and third stories. It's like just not real, not possible. You have to climb through the steps. Now, someone might say, ma'am, I only did an internship of being an analyst, the back-end jobs, or maybe just content writing. Why do I need these skills? I'm doing it virtually from my home. Like, why? Why should I care? I'll only focus on technical skills. I'm good like that. But wait, tell me, when suppose you are asked to give an article each day and there is some function at your home and you cannot provide that article, submit to your boss, and you have to write an email, how do you write it? Do you sound convincing, or do you sound desperate, or do you sound authoritative? Give me a leave. I want it. I can't do it. Give me a leave. Or you're like, please, sir, please give me. I'll make sure that I don't do this in future. This is my fault. I will never disappoint you in future. What are the words that you're using? And what is the image that you're creating in the mind of your employer at that moment? Also, when you're working in a team, even in an internship scenario, how are you building relationships? As ma'am just told us that these days, machines are taking over the work of humans. For example, cashier, teller. Now tell me, if you are doing exactly what a machine can do, then how good are you as humans? Where is the human touch? Right? you can simply be replaced. Tomorrow they'll say, see, we don't need you. We have an app for this. You can please go out and look for another job. The human touch comes in when we communicate with people, when we build relationships, when we network. Right now here, a lot of you do not know each other. You're coming from different departments, different years. When I gave you the activity of pairing up with another person, the person who was the odd one out was just sitting there, not even turning around, thinking ki main kisi se baat kar lu, kisi se apni activities share kar lu. They were just sitting there. It's all right. I understand. We all have different personalities. We have hesitations. But don't you think we are missing out on something if we do not take that step? Right now, it's a very small step sitting in the seminar hall. But tomorrow, it can be the big reason why you're not getting that promotion. Because you never had contacts or relations with the boss, with your colleagues. There was no one who could say good things about you. Maybe you were a silent hard worker and no one ever knew except for your best friend in that organization. But he never even spoke up for you because he was like you only. You both are silent workers and there's someone XYZ who's getting all the promotions. Then you wonder what's happening with my life. So we need to understand how important these skills are and we cannot miss out on this part. So the first we talked about was technical skills. Second, we talked about cognitive skills, the analytical skills, the critical thinking. Third, we're talking about the behavioral skills. And fourth are the advanced skills that we will talk about once you've mastered these three skills.